I'm here today with Manfred Riem, and Manfred's going to talk to us a little bit about how to use Azure Key Vault to secure your Azure Spring Cloud applications. Take it away, Manfred.
Thank you, Brian. So as Brian said, we're going to talk about managing secrets in Azure Key Vault. So I'm going to go over a quick agenda here so that we know what we're going to be covering here. And it will be an introduction, demo, recap, and resources. Okay, so the key question we really need to answer before we start talking about secrets is, you have traditionally an application and you have configuration. So you store configuration somewhere. If you're talking about a Spring Boot application, which is what you would use if you target Azure Spring Cloud, you would be either storing it in your application.properties or in your application.yaml. Most of the time, you know, you store configuration in there that actually needs to be kept secret. Traditional deployments, you know, you would deploy that application and those secrets are actually in the application WAR file that you're deploying. That is not a desirable scenario, specifically if you're looking at deploying an application from test to acceptance and to production, where those particular secrets could be different. So the key reason why you would use secrets is simple. You need to keep everything secret. So in Azure Spring Cloud, you have the ability to use, on the one hand, a configuration server, which will contain your configuration files. So that's the first step of keeping things more secret. But even those are available to everyone that is actually able to configure that config server. So it's not totally secret. So the next step on that particular scenario would be, okay, now let's use a key vault where you stick secrets in. And in order to do so, we're going to now show you how that works using each of the steps involved in getting that done. So we're now at the demo. And for the demo, I'm going to go to the portal, and I have pre-created the Azure Spring Cloud instance, as well as the Azure database for MySQL that we're using as an illustration of what you should secure, and then obviously the Azure Key Vault. So step one in this particular scenario is create your Key Vault. I have also pre-provisioned this one, but I'm gonna show you now that the actual Key Vault is there, and it contains some secrets that I've added. And in this particular case, it's the configuration for MySQL. So you have a database name, you have a login to the database and a password, and you have the server's full name so that you can access the server. These are the secrets that are currently set up in Azure Key Vault so that we can reconfigure the application to use those without ever showing what the actual values are. Now, if I would want to, I can actually look at these values because I actually have access to these values, but as part of securing access, you can actually define which particular users and or applications have access to the Azure Key Vault. Okay, so now we're going to go over to the application to actually show you that the Key Vault is actually being used. So here we have an application that is deployed. It's the Azure version of the well-known pet clinic application. So it has multiple services. And if I click on the vet service, and then I'm asking for the configuration of it, you will see that here you see that it actually has still the MySQL information available. So if it as environment variables. If I go to the other application that I've already configured properly, you will see that there's absolutely nothing visible. Yet each of these two applications connect to the same database. So how does that work? So in setting this up, you will need to opt into our Azure Key Vault, Secret Spring Boot Starter. You would add that to your POM file. once you've added that to your POM file, you would obviously have to build the application. But before you do, we are going to have a look at application.properties. So here you see the set of application properties that you can use if you're doing local development, because obviously, you know, as a developer, you need to be able to test things, and testing on the cloud itself for your that particular application is possible, yet a little bit cumbersome. So what I normally do is I set up everything in Azure to be able to both use a managed identity, which is what your application will use, and a client ID, client secret way of working, which is what you would use to access Azure Key Vault yourself. So that's the reason why in this particular application.properties file, you're seeing some grayed out values here. And if you are using it locally, you would actually fill in the URI, the client ID, and the tenant ID so that you have the ability to connect to Azure Key Vault using your own credentials and test your application locally before you actually deploy it to Azure Spring Cloud itself. I mentioned the config server before. This particular example is set up using the config server so that you can actually use profiles that you can switch depending on what kind of environment you're targeting. Now, in this particular case, the profile is called MySQL because we're connecting to a MySQL database. Everything you see here is the configuration that the MySQL database needs. And you can see that the properties that were configured in the Key Vault previously are also visible here. When you're locally developing, you would pass those particular properties in on the command line so that your application, when it boots up, has access to the same information. Now, the next step would be to say, okay, well, I want these variables to come from Azure Key Vault. So you would create a new profile. And in this particular case, we call this profile Key Vault. And the only thing that you add additionally to what you see on the top of the screen is in here in the bottom, where you say Azure Key Vault enabled and Azure Key Vault URI. The URI needs to be the same URI, which I will show for this particular application, is going to be found here. So this would be the URI that you would need to pass when you deploy the application, once you've done everything to get the configuration done. For in this case, for this particular example, this is the URI. In your case, it would be obviously the URI of the Key Vault you have created. So once that is all done, then this is the kind of property file you would end up with. There's nothing in here, literally. This is the property file of the application. So the only thing different between what you've done with the original application is you've pushed the majority of your configuration into the Spring Cloud config server, and then the secret information into your Azure Key Vault. And the configuration that you've done on Spring Cloud config uses properties that are known to your Azure Key Vault. So now going back to the application, back to the application. Yep, there we go. So going back to the application, you will find out then, as I said before, you know, the result would be that your visit service here has absolutely no configuration. Now, I will show you that this all works by going to the API gateway. And then the API gateway is the actual application. And you'll see that all the information pulls up. You remember that it was the visit service that is actually didn't have any configuration, but you see it's still pulling up all the information. So that is how that would work. So now to go back and recap. So in order for you to get Azure Key Vault and secrets into your Spring Boot application, you would need to opt into our Key Vault Starter. You need to enable a system managed identity for the application. You need to set up access policies, then reconfigure your application to use the stored secrets, and then deploy the application on Azure Spring Cloud with the new profile that you created, and then you're kind of done. If you're interested, the entire example with every step in there, including CI/CD, you can find at the link showing up on the screen right now. And if you have any other more questions, feel free for feedback and questions to send us, you know, an email to us at springteam@microsoft.com. Thank you.
Great recap, Manfred. Thank you very much. Really appreciate the overview and a great tip on using the environment variables when you're testing, because it's just you and there's really no reason why you should add the extra complexity and the extra perhaps fault of Key Vault right away. But yeah, great. Obviously great for security and great for securing your Azure Spring Boot applications. Thank you.
Thank you.